गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. दिस इज डॉक्टर वाई सुजाता, प्रोफेसर इन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, बीवीसी इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज, ओडल रे ऑटोनमस. प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस टूल वे, टाइप्स ऑफ टूल वेस एंड टूल लाइफ, एंड देन आफ्टर कटिंग फ्लूइड्स. नाउ वी डिस्कस द चिप थिकनेस रेशियो, मर्चन सर्किल फॉर्मुलास, एंड वट आर द फोर्सेस एक्टिंग ऑन देयर मर्चन सर्किल डायग्राम. That formulas we take the, we solved the problems here in this lecture. So first we discuss chip thickness ratio problem. First we discuss here chip thickness ratio. Here first problem you understand that, and one time you read it. In a machining operations of a cutting, the cutting tool rack angle alpha is equal to chip thickness before cut. T is equal to 0.5 mm. And is the thickness after cut TC is equal to 1.125 mm. Calculate the shear plane angle and the shear strain the operations. Shear plane angle, in this chip thickness ratio already you know that R is equal to T divided by T naught, that is the chip thickness ratio. And in this problem they are asked that shear, find the shear angle. With the help of R we identified the shear angle. Given data, what are the given data are there here? Alpha is equal to rack angle 10 and T is equal to 0.50 mm. TC is equal to 1.25 mm, 1.125 mm, and find the phi is equal to and gamma. First we know that chip thickness ratio formula, already you know that. What is the chip thickness ratio? Gamma is equal to T divided by TC. Here gamma is equal to T divided by TC is equal to 0.50 divided by T is the 0.50. This is the before cut. Chip thickness ratio is equal to before cut divided by after cut. Before cut is the T and TC is the after cut 1.125. Here 0.50 divided by 1.25 is equal to 0.44 mm is the chip thickness ratio. And then next you find out the shear plane angle. They are asked that shear plane angle. Shear plane angle, in given data only three terms are there. That is, first we identified the T and TC are already they are given in the problem. That help of the data we take here, gamma is equal to T divided by TC. 0.50, 1.125 is equal to 0.44, and then we find out the next tan phi is equal to, this is standard formula of shear angle, R cos alpha divided by 1 minus R sin alpha, then is equal to R is equal to 0.44 cos alpha means rack angle 10 degrees in the problem they are given data, 1 minus 0.44 here. 1 minus 0.44 sin angle 10 and tan phi is equal to 0. Here phi is equal to 25.310. Then shear strain is equal to tan phi minus alpha plus cot phi. Tan phi is that in shear plane, tan phi, how much they we get it? 25.13. Alpha is the 10 and cot 25.13. So both are 2.40. At the same time in question, chip thickness ratio 6.2 mm, feet 2 mm revolutions, rack angle is equal to 15. Calculate the cutting rate and chip reduction coefficient. Chip thickness ratio is the T divided by TC. Chip reduction coefficient is equal to 1 by R. Chip reduction coefficient K is equal to 1 by R, and then and shear angle and calculate. This is the next problem. Same data in chip thickness in orthogonal cutting process. Chip thickness is 62 mm and feet 2 mm revolutions per seconds. Rack angle alpha is equal to 15 degrees. Calculate the ratio and chip reduction coefficient and shear angle. Calculate the determined shear strain involved in process. That is the two. In problem they are given that T is equal to, here same T is the 2 mm, TC is the 6.2 mm, alpha is equal to 15. In above problem, feed is equal to mm per revolutions. Gamma is equal to, they are given chip reduction coefficient, they are asked that, and determine the shear angle. We find out the 2. Chip reduction coefficient is equal to 0.2 divided by 0.62 is equal to 0.322. Chip reduction coefficient 1 by r. 1 by r means 1 by chip thickness ratio. R is equal to, already we find out what is that r, 0.332. 1 by 332 is equal to 3.105 is the chip reduction coefficient. Tan phi is equal to shear angle. R cos alpha divided by 1 minus r sin alpha. Alpha here in this problem is a first problem, they are given the 10 degrees. Second problem, alpha is equal to 15 degrees. Same, phi is equal to tan inverse r cos alpha divided by 1 minus r sin alpha. We substitute the values of r and alpha, sin cos. Then we got that shear angle is equal to 18.72. Next, that shear strain is equal to tan phi minus alpha plus cot phi. Shear strain formula is the tan phi minus alpha plus cot phi minus phi. Tan phi is the almost, you find out that 18 minus 72. 18 minus 72 minus alpha is the 15, and plus cot phi value here. We substitute 18.7.2. Same, phi is the shear angle. Here, how much we got that? 0.065017 plus 0. Finally, we got that 3.15. So, two problems we are done here. Chip thickness ratio, already we solved the two problems. Next, we discuss the here numerical based on the cutting forces and merchant force circle diagram. Previous lecture we discussed merchant force circle diagram, what are the forces are acting on there, and formulas also. Now we discuss here problems, what are the formulas we use and what are the given data and how we solve it. In this lecture we understand that first you study the problem. In orthogonal cutting process, the following data have been observed. That here first you understand that what are the given data in the problem are there. Uncut chip thickness, width of cut, cutting speed, rack angle, cutting forces, thrust to force, and chip thickness TC is equal to, and determine the shear angle, the friction angle, shear stress along the shear plane, and the power of the cutting operation. Also find the chip velocity, shear strain in chip, and shear strain rate. Here first they are given that uncut chip thickness means T, 0.127 mm, width of the cut is equal to B, cutting speed is equal to V, alpha rack angle is equal to 10 degrees, and cutting force Fc is equal to Ft, and chip thickness. And what we find it here, you observe that in this problem. And next, what first we note down the what is the given data they are given. And what we find out next here, left side first, we note down that what are the, they are given in the problem, given data. And next, what they are asked to find out and determine. And then they are given the above problem, width of the thickness and uncut chip thickness T, and width of the speed B, velocity V, alpha, rack angle. And Fc is the cutting force, Ft is the thrust to force, and next Tc, chip thickness. Chip thickness means after cutting, and above is the before cutting. And next here, what they are asked to determine, shear angle means phi, and friction angle is the beta, and tau s is the shear stress along shear plane. Shear angle phi, we called the phi is the shear angle, beta is the friction angle, tau s is the shear plane and shear power, cutting operation. Now next, Vc is equal to cutting velocity, cutting chip velocity. Okay, cutting chip velocity. VC is the cutting chip. Next S, S is the shear strain in chip and shear strain rate. S is the shear strain and shear plane length, shear strain rate. Shear plane length, one by one we find out first any problem, first we find out the chip thickness ratio. Already in before two problems you understand that how you calculate the chip thickness ratio, or is equal to uncut chip thickness divided by cut chip thickness. Before cutting, after cutting is equal to 0.127 divided by 0.228. How much we got? 0.557 mm. Next we find out the shear angle. Shear angle formula, what is the shear angle formula? Tan phi is equal to r cos alpha divided by 1 minus r sin alpha. Almost you know that what are the terms. Shear phi is the shear angle. Here r is the chip thickness ratio. Alpha is the, they are given the alpha, how much shear rack alpha, how much 10. Alpha here rack angle, alpha is equal to 10 or and sin alpha. Tan phi is equal to 0.557 cos 10 divided by 1 minus 0.557 sin 10. Here 0.557 is the value of the r, and cos alpha means rack angle 10, 1 minus 0.557 sin alpha. Same here we find out, we use the inequality. After that we got that phi value. Phi is equal to tan inverse into r cos alpha divided by 1 minus r sin alpha. This is the shear angle formula. Next, friction angle. Friction angle is equal to tan beta is equal to mu. Mu is equal to F by N. F is equal to Fc sin alpha plus Ft cos alpha, and Fc cos alpha plus Ft sin alpha. Here almost Fc is the cutting force, Ft is the thrust force. Alpha is the rack angle. You know that. What are the terms are there? You substitute here. Alpha is equal to Fc is the 567 and sin alpha plus Ft is the 227 and cos alpha. Downside also same. Then we got that 0.64. Beta is equal to 32.62 is the value. And next same here also shear force. Shear force is equal to Fc cos phi minus Ft sin phi. Fc is the cutting force, Ft is the thrust force. Phi is equal to shear angle. All terms are, we know that Fc is the, they are given in the problem, Ft also they are given in the problem. Phi is the shear angle we find out, and next we substitute the here values, then we got that Fc is equal to 367 N. And next we find out the shear stresses. Shear stress or tau s is equal to Fs divided by As. Fs is equal to Fs into sin phi divided by B into T. Fs is the shear 367. Here we find out shear force. Fs is the shear force 367 into sin 367 into sin phi is the 31.25. And next same here downside, As is equal to B into T. In the problem, B is the width of the thickness. They are given that 0.127. Same, B is the 6.35 into T is the 0.127. So we got that how much? 236.5 N per mm square. So must we use the calci? Without calci we can't get the values easily and fast. Here also same, cutting force Fc is equal to cutting force Vc is equal to Fc into V divided by 1000. 567 is the Fc and V is the 2, velocity and 1000. Where will you get V is the velocity 2? Here above problem you observed that. Where is the V? Here V is the 2. That means here V is equal to cutting speed is equal to 2 m per seconds. They are given that already in the problem. In that 2e here we take that 2 is the in this cutting power is equal to. Next, chip velocity gamma is equal to Vc by V. Here Vc is equal to V into R. V into R. Here cross multiplication we got that Vc is equal to V into R. 2 into 0.557 equal to 1.114 m per seconds. Next, shear strain. Shear strain S is equal to cot 5 plus tan 5 minus alpha. Same 5 also we know that cot, and 5 minus alpha also we know that here. This is a bracket close. And next cot 31.25 plus tan 31.25 minus 10. That means 21.25. Next S is equal to 2.037. Shear plane length is equal to T divided by sin 5. Shear plane length T is equal to divided by sin 5 is equal to 0.127 divided by sin 31.25 is equal to 0.245 mm value. And next here, chip thickness determination of the zone equal to one length of shear plane length. They are asked that chip thickness deformation zone equal to one length of the shear plane length. TS is equal to 0.0245 maximum. Cap be taken 25 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Here Vs is equal to V cos alpha divided by cos pi minus alpha. Vs is equal to V cos alpha equal to cos pi minus alpha. Now 2 cos 10 cos into 31.25 minus 10, we got the 2.11 m per seconds. Next shear strain, last we find out but one, shear strain rate S is equal to Vs by Ts. You remember that formulas, Vs is equal to Ts is equal to 2.11 into 1000 divided by 0.0245. Shear strain rate S is equal to Vs by Ts. So S is equal to 86.12 into 10 to the power of minus 1 into S. So all terms what they are asked to, I determine. So total we determine the shear strain rate, and next shear plane, shear strain, shear plane length, shear strain, chip velocity, cutting power, and shear stress, shear force, friction angle, shear angle, chip thickness ratio. That means you find out the 8 terms you identified here, 8 formulas also you know. In this way you solve the every problem in merchant circle diagram and single point cutting tool. Okay, now we discuss the next second problem we discuss. During the orthogonal machining turning operations, C40 steel the following data were obtained. Here what are they are given, that this values, chip thickness ratio, width of the cut, feed, tangential cut force, feed thrust force FT, cutting speed V, rack angle alpha. What are they we calculate here? Force of the shear at the shear plane, kinematic coefficient of friction at the chip tool surface. Only they are asked that only two here. Shear plane angle, find the Fs shear force, and kinematic coefficient of friction is the mu. So first we note down that here given data, what they are given in the problem, TC is equal to chip thickness ratio, and width B is equal to width of the cut, alpha is equal to rack angle, T is equal to F is equal to 0.25, FC is equal to tangential cut force 1130, and FT is equal to feed thrust force 295 N, V is equal to 2.5 m per seconds, cutting speed, and rack angle alpha is equal to 10. Here we find out the shear force Fs is equal to, and kinematic coefficient of friction mu is equal to. Then next we find out the first here, what anything we find out the first chip thickness ratio, R is equal to T divided by TC, and cut before cutting, after cutting, 0.25 divided by 0.25, before cutting, after cutting, before cutting. Chip thickness ratio R is equal to T divided by TC is equal to 0.55, and next we find out the tan phi is equal to R cos alpha divided by 1 minus R sin alpha. Here 0.R is the 0.55, and alpha is equal to rack angle 10. Then we substitute the values in this formula. We got that phi is equal to tan inverse R cos alpha divided by 1 minus R sin alpha. In this way, we calculated here, we got the 31.2 is a 5. And next shear force, Fs is equal to Fc cos phi minus Ft sin phi. Fc is the cutting force and Ft is the thrust force. 1130, phi is the 31.2. Above we calculate here, phi is equal to 31.2 and Fc and Ft are the given data in the problem. Next we got that shear force Fs is equal to 834.N. And then friction angle tan beta is equal to friction angle is equal to F by N. Where is the F is equal to Fc sin alpha plus Ft cos alpha divided by N is equal to Fc cos alpha plus Ft sin alpha. So here we got that equal to Fc is the cutting force and sin alpha is equal to 10. Fc is the thrust force, cos alpha same downside also, Fc cos alpha plus Ft sin alpha. We substitute the values. We got that mu is equal to 0.458. And then we discuss the next problem also same. First we understand what they are given the data and that what they are asked to find out. Here also same chip thickness ratio and feed 0.2 and rank angle 15. And then what we calculate here? Calculate the cutting ratio and chip reduction coefficient, shear angle, shear strain involved in the deformation process. That means chip thickness ratio and chip reduction coefficient and shear angle and shear strain. Four terms are we find out the here. So then in orthogonal cutting process here they are given that first we find out the chip thickness ratio. Chip thickness ratio gamma is equal to T divided by Tc is equal to 0.2 divided by 0.62 before cutting process, after cutting, before cutting width divided by after cutting 0.322. that is the chip thickness ratio formula. So next we find out the chip reduction coefficient. What is the chip reduction coefficient here? K or chip reduction coefficient is equal to 1 by r. 1 by r means 1 by 0.322, or Tc divided by T also. That way also we calculate the chip reduction coefficient, Tc divided by T also we calculate. In this way we got that 3.1. Next shear angle. Shear angle tan phi is equal to r cos alpha divided by 1 minus r sin alpha equal to 0.322 cos 15 divided by 1 minus 0.322 sin 15. Here shear angle is equal to, we substitute the what are the given data in the problem are there, r, and next we find out the alpha also is there, and next r is the 0.22 cos 15 sin 15. We calculate the, we got that phi shear angle tan phi. Phi is equal to tan inverse into r cos alpha divided by 1 minus r sin alpha. So shear strain S is equal to cot phi plus tan phi minus alpha. Cot phi is the cot and phi is the 18.74 before we calculate that, and plus tan phi minus alpha. Alpha is the 15. Then we got that in this way we calculate here S is equal to 3.012 mm. In this way we find out the term, four terms are we find out the chip thickness ratio, chip reduction coefficient, shear angle, shear strain. These are the formulas we used in the, and at the same time we take the help of given data we find out these terms. And next we discuss the one more problem here. The following the data from an orthogonal cutting test is available. Rank angle is equal to 15 degrees, chip thickness ratio 0.3830, uncut chip thickness 0.5 mm, and width of the cut B, yield stress in shear, coefficient of friction 0.7, and determine the material and tangential forces on the tool. That means what we find out here, given data alpha, R, T, B, tau s and mu, F and N we find out here. F and mean means here determine the material and tangential force and tool force, tool face and tangential force means normal forces. Given data means alpha rank angle and R is the chip thickness ratio. Directly they are given that chip thickness ratio R is equal to T divided by Tc, and T is equal to 0.5 mm, width of the cut B is equal to 3 mm, yield stress 280 mm, mu is equal to 0.7 mm. At the same time, first they are given that directly chip thickness ratio, that's why we no need to find out the chip thickness ratio here. That's why directly we find out the shear angle tan phi is equal to r cos alpha divided by 1 minus r sin alpha. Tan phi is equal to r is equal to 0.383. In the problem they are given that cos alpha is the 15, 1 minus 0.383 sin 15. R phi is equal to tan inverse r cos alpha divided by 1 minus r sin alpha. Then we got that phi is equal to 22.35. Friction angle tan beta is equal to mu. Mu is equal to F by N. Tan beta is equal to mu is equal to F by N 0.7. So they are given the problem here. Beta is equal to tan inverse into tan inverse. Beta is equal to tan inverse. So tan inverse is the 0.735. Then shear force. Now we find the value of Fc with the help of shear stress equation. Shear force tau s is equal to Fc secant beta minus alpha cos bracket open 5 plus into beta minus alpha bracket close sin phi divided by beta t. Fc is equal to tau s beta t. Here we take the Fc is the in this side and then we cross multiply this tau s into beta t and next we put the here same as above is the formula secant beta minus alpha cos 5 plus beta minus alpha into sin phi. So fc is equal to 280 into 3 into 0.5 secant 35 minus, we substitute the water, the values are there from our side, so we got that fc is equal to 1405.7 n. Then we find out the next friction angle mu is equal to F by N is equal to Fc sin alpha plus Ft cos alpha. You know that familiar before three problems we repeated that friction angle beta is equal to mu is equal to F by N Fc sin alpha plus Ft cos alpha divided by Fc cos alpha minus Ft sin alpha equal to 1405.7 sin 15 plus Ft cos 15 divided by 1405.7 sin 15 minus Ft sin 15. So mu already previous above we calculate that mu is the 0.7. So what they we don't know here Ft. So we find out the Ft is the force. Ft is the thrust force. So here we find out cross multiplication 0.7 into and same here also. Then we got that Ft is equal to 511.46 N. Then tangential force on the tool face Fc is equal to F sin alpha plus Ft cos alpha. Ft cos alpha 14.0 then sin 15 same we got that F is equal to 858 N. Then normal force on tool face is equal to N is equal to Fc cos alpha minus Ft sin alpha equal to Fc. They are given the problem Fc and next cos 15 and F 511.46 sin 15 we got that 11225.4 n. So in this way we find out the formulas what we use here in this problem. 3 we find out the tangential force and normal force and mu. Okay, next we discuss the single point cutting tool angles. Already previous lectures also we discussed the what are the single point cutting tools angles are there or tool signatures. Single point cutting tool angles are two is called as tool signature. Tool signatures and angles of the single point cutting tool are having seven types. What are they? First in this way they are given that seven elements 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. One by one we discuss here then we solve the problem also. In the tool signature they are given the problems also this topic. 8 is the back rack angle. First we identified here back rack angle. Next 14 is the side rack angle and 6 is the end relief angle and 8 is the side relief angle and next 8 is the end cutting edge angle. Back rack angle, side rack angle, end relief angle, साइड रिलीफ एंगल, एंड कटिंग एज एंगल, व्हाट इज द रिमेनिंग आर देयर, साइड कटिंग एज एंगल. नेक्स्ट दिस इज द 19 इज द साइड कटिंग एज एंगल. लास्ट बट वन इज द लास्ट वन इज द नोस रेडियस. वन इज द नोस नोस रेडियस. व्हाट आर दे हियर, सेवन एलिमेंट्स आर देयर, बैक रैक एंगल, साइड रैक एंगल, एंड रिलीफ एंगल, साइड रिलीफ एंगल, एंड कटिंग एज एंगल, साइड कटिंग एज एंगल, नोस रेडियस. दिस आर द सेवन एलिमेंट्स ऑफ द सिंगल पॉइंट कटिंग टूल आर टूल सिग्नेचर वी कॉल्ड एज. वन मोर टाइम वी रिपीट हियर बिकॉज वी सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन दिस टॉपिक नाउ. दैट्स वाई आई विल रिपीट वन मोर टाइम. Okay, two signatures are, or two angles, or two elements are there here. Seven, side rack angle, back rack angle, side rack angle, end relief angle, side relief angle, end cutting edge angle, side cutting edge angle, and nose radius. In this problem, you observe that here, previous slide we discussed the single point tool signature. Same six, seven elements are there. In this problem, they are given that in a single point cutting tool used in turning a geometry as per ASA is back rack angle, side cutting edge angle. These three are the three elements are given that find out the values of inclination, inclination angle and rack angle in ORS tool NAMO culture. So given data as per ASA alpha B, back rack angle is alpha B is equal to 8, side rack angle alpha S. And CS alpha we find out and I here ORS NAMO culture we find out the approach angle lambda is equal to approach angle 90 minus CS 90 and CS is the cutting side cutting edge angle 15 degrees. So 90 minus 15 is equal to 75. By using the conversion of this equation, orthogonal rack angle tan alpha is equal to tan alpha is equal to tan alpha s into sin lambda plus tan alpha b into cos lambda. Tan alpha 4 tan alpha is the rack s alpha s side rack angle. It is that what is that side rack angle is the 4 and alpha b back rack angle is 8. Here alpha we get 5.56. then inclination angle tan I is equal to, these are the formulas, tan I is equal to minus tan alpha plus cos lambda plus tan alpha b into sin lambda. Lambda also we find out that. So tan 4 cos 75 plus tan 8 sin 75, we got that 6.67. In this way we calculate the here. Next we discuss the here tool life problems. Already in previous lecture we discussed the what is the tool life and tool wears. Tool life formula, Tyler's formula, V to the power of n is equal to C, and based on that formula we find out the, we solve the some problems here. First example, you observe that here when machining got 50 m per minute, the tool life noted as 100 minutes. Calculate the tool life if a similar tool cuts at 20% higher speed. Also find out the cutting speed if the tool is required to machine for 170 minutes without failing. Take n is equal to 0.27, Tyler's tool life equation. So already we know that n is equal to constant, some materials they are given that here given data V is equal to 50 when machining at speed and tool life T is equal to 100 mm. And calculate the V1 is equal to here 20 point higher. So 1.2 into V is equal to 1.2 into V is the 50 is equal to 60. N is equal to 0.27 and T2 is equal to 170 mm. Here directly they are given that cutting speed of the tool is required for the machine 170 mm. We find out the C, VT and T1. According to in the Tyler's formula, you know that before V to the power of n is equal to C, V is the speed, T is the tool life and C is the constant. So V is equal to 50, T is equal to 100, T to the power of n is equal to 0.27 is equal to C. So we find out the C is equal to 173.36. We used here calci. So easily we get that. Next calculation for tool life and cutting speed is similar to 20% higher. In the previous problem, they are asked that V1 and V2 also. Here they are asked that V1 is equal to 1.2 into 50 is equal to 60 mm. So V1 T1 to the power of n is equal to C. Here V1 is equal to and T1 is equal to C divided by V1 whole to the power of 1 by n. So here C is equal to, we find out that 173.36 divided by V1 is equal to 60 whole to the power of 1 by n means 1 by 0.27. What is the value we got that here? T1 is equal to 50.90 minutes. Now we find out the cutting velocity also. V2 is equal to V2 T2 to the power of n is equal to C. We find out the here V2 is equal to C divided by T2 power of n. So C divided by to the power of n. Here we find out the T1. Here we find out the V2. T1 and V2 values in this way, you same formula we use that V1 T1 to the power of n equal to C. V2 T2 to the power of n is equal to C. So we shifted here in this way, we calculate the T1 and V2. Next we discuss the one more problem, same that's why you easily understand that here. In a machining test, the following the values of tool life is observed. V is equal to 0.4 and T is equal to 32, 1.1 and 1.6. Find the values of coefficient of n and C. Taylor's of tool equation also find out the cutting speed of the tool life is 60. Here given data, V1 is equal to 0.4. 24 m per seconds and Vt is equal to 1.1 66 m per seconds m per minutes. They are given that m per seconds. We calculate the m per minutes. Seconds to we change the minutes and T2 is equal to 32, T1 is equal to 1.6. So T3 is equal to, we find the 60. Here also cutting speed tool life is the T3. So we find out the C, N, V3. V1, V2 all also we know that. Here V3 is not there and T1, T2, T3 they are given. In this we substitute according to Taylor's formula V2, V1, T1 to the power of n is equal to V2, T2 to the power of n is equal to C. V1 divided by V2 is equal to T2, V1 divided by V2 is equal to T2 divided by T1 whole to the power of n. N here we log. We substitute the log V1 divided by V2 is equal to N log T2 divided by T1. So log how we calculate, you know that in the calculus log 0.4 divided by 1.1 and N is equal to log 1.6 divided by 32. N is equal to 0.337. By putting the value of in Taylor's equation, we get the coefficient of C is equal to 24 into 32 into 0.337 is equal to C. C is equal to 77.169 for cutting the velocity 60 minutes per tool life. V3 T3 to the power of n is equal to C. Here V3 60, 0.337 equal to 77.169. So in that way we got that how much the value we got that V3 is equal to 19.41 m per minutes. So next we discuss the third problem. Here third problem, the useful tool life of a high speed steel tool machining mild steel at 18 m per minutes is 3 hours calculated the tool life when the tool operates at 24 m per minutes. The given data here, V is equal to 18 m per minutes and T is equal to 3 into 60, N is equal to 0.125, V1 is equal to 24. What we find out the here, they are given that only V, T, N and V1. So we find out the T1. According to the Taylor's formula, V to the power of N is equal to C. So V is the 18, T to the power of N is the 0.125, C is equal to 34.45. So for the life, if velocity 24 minutes per minutes, V1 T1 to the power of n is equal to C. V1 T1 to the power of n is equal to C. T1 is equal to, we shift the C divided T1 is equal to C divided by V1 whole to the power of 1 by n. So, in this way 34.45 divided by 24. So, how much we got? The T1 is equal to 18 mm. So, then in this way we calculate the T1 value. So, first we consider the formulas of here V to the power of n is equal to C. Next, third problem, using the Taylor's equation, using n is equal to 0.5, C is equal to 400, calculate the percentage increases in tool life when cutting speed is reached by 50%. So, you read it one time in problem here and then you note down the given data and what they are asked here, find out percentage of increases of tool life. So, in given data n is equal to 0.5, C is equal to 400 and Vt is equal to 0.5 into V1. So, according to the Taylor's formula of tool life equation, V1 T1 to the power of n is equal to V2 T2 to the power of n is equal to C. In that's why V2 0.5 into V1 T2 to the power of n. So, here that's why we got that T2 divided by T1, T2 divided by T1 whole to the power of n is equal to 2. Here, next percentage of increases T2 minus T1 divided by T1 into 100. T2 minus T1 divided by T1 into 100. What is the T2 here? How much T2? T2 is equal to 4 into T1. So, what is the T2? You know that here. First, T1 almost you know that here. Okay, percentage of increases T2 minus T1 divided by T1 into 100. T2 is equal to 4T1 minus T1 divided by T1 into 100. 4T1 minus T1 is equal to 3T1 divided by T1 into 100. T1, T1 is a cancel. So, 3 divided by 1 is equal to 300. In this way, we calculate the percentage of increases in T2 here. So, today we end this lecture. Thanks for listening this lecture. What we discuss in this lecture means chip thickness ratio problems based on the chip thickness ratio problems, and then after merchant circle forces problems, and then next tool life problems. So, you take the solve different problems in manufacturing technology test books, Raghuvamsi and Kalpak Jain. In production technology and manufacturing technology, we follow one and deep, you solve the different type of problems. So, then we got the knowledge of how to solve the different type of problems. So, thanks for listening this lecture.